Hey guys, Professor Tom here. We're gonna have an awesome time looking at turtle attacks. Heaps of different attacks from turtle. Let's take a look. All right, let's have a look at turtle. So when someone gets to their hands and knees, at the end of the day, guys, you have to respect this. Now, understand it has its place in martial arts. Obviously, jiu-jitsu is a martial art. So don't feel too comfortable being here, you know, if someone could attack you or hit you on the street. You know, this is not where you want to be by choice, unless you don't wish to practice truly, I guess, as a combative martial artist. The thing is, a lot of what we do in jiu-jitsu isn't specifically for combative martial arts. It's for jiu-jitsu, and by doing jiu-jitsu, we fit strong, healthy, and combative, and we can defend ourselves on the street. But when you're in this position, guys get strong. People specialize in this. You know, people like Eduardo Teles specializing in the turtle guard. So let's have a look at how we can attack it. Now, starting basic stuff, guys, I already have a video of attacking, okay, the Dar series here, okay? I already have a video on that that you can see. I also have a look at rolling back takes as well, okay? So you can see a few of those. However, today I want to look at everything else. So if you can't get the Das, maybe if you can't get to that back, let's have a look at what else we can do from here. Primarily, I'm looking to attack one of the limbs on the near side. Normally, this is a good use, and if I can use my legs, all the better. These are obviously big, strong weapons, and these here are the closest vulnerable parts of my partner. So let's have a look at how we can use the legs to attack the legs. So from here, whether it's gi or no gi, I can shunt him forwards here to try to open up some space. Be careful doing this. Don't slam your partner's nose into the mat. And then from this position here, I can step my near leg in and around. And if you have a look, you can see how I'm dorsiflexing my foot to come in here under the shin. Now from this position, you can't leave space. If you leave space, he just gets an underhook, and you're now in half guard with all the wrong positioning. So once we get to this position, make sure you stay tight and really using that elbow to clamp, not really your hands, this way. From this position now, I'm gonna step straight in to my attacking position. So my left foot's gonna come here between our feet, okay? So from this position, holding the shin, I'm going to now plantar flex my foot, put my other foot in, and now I hold two on one and bring this guy to me as I extend my legs. From this position here, we have a lockdown, and so this guy's not going very fast. One of the most important things that I like to do is ensure that his hips are on top of my midsection. I don't want to be over here like this, because if his hips aren't on top of mine, with just a throw of his leg this way, he can start to expose my back, okay? So this is the last thing I want, some guy choking my back. So from hands and knees again, I can shunt him forward here to create some space, and now come in and hold tight. From this position here, if they're to roll with you, etc., this way, it's no problem, we could forward roll it. But in most situations, he's gonna stay pretty tight. So, I step and I hold the leg, two on one. Now, as I bring him back, I ensure his hips come on top of me, and I keep his foot very close to my chest and face. From this position, some simple series, guys. One, two, okay, and now I just focus on pulling his knees apart like I'm pulling apart the wishbone of a chicken, okay? From this position also, of course, if I can't spread them apart, I can bring it down and get a fantastic compression calf slice lock here. Of course, if you're a points guy, you'll be more than familiar with people taking the back from this position. From this position, guys, you've got a great high-lower hook, and you're really ready to get the attacks going, okay? So that's just something you can do from that position. Again, if I put my leg into this position, guys, like this, this is actually not too hard to do, you'd be surprised. Sometimes they fall away because they fear their back's exposed, and then just roll through, okay? Straight to your Barambolo roll. And although this may sound complicated, it's not, guys. Just do these techniques, they're not hard. We're all human, we all kind of feel and move the same way. You won't have too much trouble. But we also need to now have a look at attacking the arm, okay? So if he's in turtle position again, all right? And I can't get hooks in, I can't hit my das, I'm going to try to pry apart his arm using my stronger, bigger legs. So from this control position, I'm gonna put my knee in right between his femur and his rib cage here. And then I'm gonna slide it down this slope, just like I'm tobogganing down a ski slope here, until I get to the ground. From this position here, I should be able to see my knee. Now, look guys, I can get this quite easy. Sometimes you can play a dummy game and do this and put your foot here and he grabs it, but that's kind of like a sucker move because I can just take his arm. And after a while, you know, your training partners won't be suckers. So by driving my knee through, I can now bring my foot through and touch my heel to the inside of my knee. At this point, I can clamp my knee in and kick back, okay? And now here I am in an awesome crucifix position. So right now, my right leg is controlling his arm. Now, from this position, we have a whole bunch of attacks, not to mention rear naked chokes, etc. But not even looking at crucifix attacks for now. Let's look at the armbar, a tried and true attack you all know and do. If my right leg controls his right arm, his left arm is quite vulnerable. Let's have a look how we attack it. A right hand goes down, and while keeping a right hamstring curl, my left leg steps over and hook goes in. Now from this position, I'm gonna do a forward roll. And thank goodness that I was doing my leg curl because the control of this arm gives me an incredibly long lever to rotate my partner. And now without even moving my feet, by clamping my knees together, I have a posture broken, hyper controlled guy here, ready for an easy tap. Certainly well below I need to bridge. Obviously keep the thumb up and please do your groin a favor and put it on the hip. Not only if they step out guys, just don't try to break people's arms with like a bladder. So let's have a look at this rolling armbar one more time. So anytime we're in this position, we can always try to penetrate this space till we can see our knee. Anytime we can do that, we can look at getting a crucifix control on his arm, okay? At this point, I can base to the front while I step my foot in and I roll him over, squeezing my knees and ending out in a very strong armbar. The beauty of this armbar is if he tries to stack up into me, good luck with this. It's like, there's no strength. I'm not exerting any force. I'm holding this all loose. This is just structure, okay? I can hold tight and everything and keep him still, but it's just structure. If he tries to do the running man or hitchhiker escape, right? It's just inherently held in, right? He can't pivot over his own arm. He gets stuck and I got this guy. All right, so there you have it. Two ways of attacking the turtle that you can have some fun with. Obviously from the turtle, things like back takes, keeping strong chest to back pressure, should always take precedence over attacks. But sometimes, you know, if a guy goes to turtle, quite often he doesn't really want to fight. He just wants to stay there. And if he just stays there defending, these are two killer attacks that will get you lots of fun taps. If not, he'll get out and the stall will be broken, which is best for you in the long run anyway. More jiu-jitsu means more failing, more winning, more learning. Have fun, guys. Take care.